surprised to see this. So which offense can get anything going? Maybe the team that wins this game.
Well, you saw from watching TV, going from right to left, that's when you'll have a chance to attack downfield a little bit more with the pass, and you adjust your game plan accordingly as opposed to going left to right where we're seeing a lot of short passes.
With the wind as big a factor as it is today, Chris, the Browns won the toss and they deferred their choice to the second half. Now, normally you'd say the Browns would take the football to start the second half. Is the wind a big enough deal that they might choose to make sure they have the wind in the fourth quarter?
It may very well be. I doubt that you give up a possession, though, but I wouldn't be surprised if they did it, but I don't see them giving up a possession.
Kickoff through the end zone as we head back to Los Angeles, where Carissa Thompson has an update.
Thanks, Kevin. Rams Dolphins tied at 7. Jared Goff sacked by Emmanuel Ogbah, recovered. Fumble recovered by Andrew Van Ginkel. Guess what? Returned 78 yards for the score. Tua appreciates his defense here. Dolphins leading this one 14-7. Kevin?
What a run by Andrew Van Ginkel going all the way back.
Nobody catching him.
So the Browns will start at their 25-yard line. The Ernest Johnson, the running back, behind Andy Janovich, the fullback. Mayfield on that bootleg to the sideline, trying to get both feet in is Rashard Higgins, and it's out of bounds. An injury update with Laura Oakman.
I got a few. Chris talked about how important this is in the trenches right now, and guys are paying the price from the Raiders side. Maurice Hurst, we saw him leave the field earlier, ankle questionable. Sam Young, the right tackle, we saw him limp off. He is questionable with the knee. While for the Browns, Myles Garrett left the game earlier with a knee contusion. He did come back in, but guys are getting beat up in there.
It is not a day for the faint of heart. Johnson, not much there at all. In fact, stacked up the line of scrimmage. Brings up third and long for Cleveland. 5 minutes remaining in this first half. Some sleet and snow falling here in Cleveland. It has gotten colder. The wind is blowing. I will add no more because Laura will tell me it's much worse than what I'm actually saying up here in the booth. And movement up front.
Ball start.
Wills.
Offense number 71. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
So right here, I don't know if you're confident with throwing the ball down the field 15 plus yards. So you want to get the ball into your playmaker's hands in space, whether that's Njoku, Jarvis Landry. I don't know if you want to take a risk of having the ball get away from your quarterback thrown into this wind.
On third and 15, set up the screen, goes right through the hands of Janovich. That's incomplete. And it's fourth down.
Yeah, and the aggressiveness of how Paul Gunther is calling this game, it's totally different, and it's clear they're using Abrams as your blitzing guy. And Janovich drops the ball, but Las Vegas was there, just in case it was completed. But a good play call by that man right there, who was, you know, people were wondering about his future as a Las Vegas defensive coordinator.
Jamie Gillen will punt it away. Remember, watch the tracking of the ball on punts. It was a real challenge in warm-ups. Hunter Renfrow has that task right now. And Renfrow has to go all the way back to the 24 to get this one. He did a nice job of tracking that one as it nearly sailed over his head. And he's down at the 33-yard line in the arms of Steven Carlson. Renfrow had to backpedal a bit, but fields it amidst the wind.
T-Mobile, we believe you should get more. That's why we merged with Sprint. Now, it's about to get even better. And as we work to integrate Sprint's network, our nationwide 5G keeps getting stronger, with the capacity and coverage to reach more people and places across the country. Who says you can't have it all? Now is the time for
so their laundry smells more amazing than ever.
Isn't that the dog's towel?
Hey, me towel, suit towel. More Gain scent plus Oxy Boost and Febreze in every Gain flame.
I'm just gonna grab a burger.
Oh, you think that's a bad move?
So you're saying I should go to Subway for a delicious footlong? Amazing speech, coach.
I know.
Now in the app, get a free footlong when you buy two, because it's footlong season.
That's half the fun of a new house, seeing what people left behind in the attic.
Well, saving on homeowners insurance with Geico's help was pretty fun, too.
Oh, it's a tiny dancer.
They left a ton of stuff up here.
Well, enjoy your house.
Nope. No, thank you.
Geico could help you save on homeowners and renters insurance.
The legend John Madden, 10 years as Raider head coach, a 76% winning percentage, Super Bowl champion, AFL coach of the year, Pro Football Hall of Fame inductee. He'd like this weather. He'd take a day like this.
Well,
you know Coach Madden would be out there.
I want to say hello to him because I know that he watches a lot of Raiders games. And then, Coach, if you're watching, I hope you're doing well. Set the standard for a lot of people
in a lot of different ways, both as a coach and a broadcaster. And a video game maker.
Yeah.
Second down for John Gruden's Raiders. On second down, Carr finds Witten, who hangs on for the first down at the 46-yard line. Quickly, we go to Carissa Thompson in L.A.
Thanks, Kevin. Dolphins up 14-7 when Jakeem Grant takes this punt all the way. 88 yards. Tua getting help from his defense and special teams today. Dolphins leading this one 21-7. Kevin?
Tua, special teams, all providing a spark for Miami. Jacobs. A hole up the middle, and Josh Jacobs into Browns territory at the 47-yard line.
So
DJ Goodson with a stop.
You're bringing Kevin Johnson off the edge as a blitzer, right? So that means everybody inside of Kevin Johnson has to get down a gap. If you don't get down a gap, you're going to be outnumbered. Kevin Johnson's going to come off your screen. You got to be here. You got to be here. You got to be here. And what happens is everybody gets whitewashed to the right side looking at the screen, creating that hole.
And Josh Jacobs taking advantage of that holding at those 7 yards. Now on second and three, it's Jacobs again. And Jacobs right into the pile, pushes forward near the 43 for a first down.
It's not pretty, but I'm going to tell you that Coach Gruden is probably smiling deep inside to see his offensive line and his guys respond to wanting to be physical. And he told us, we got to get back to running the football. And they're doing it today.
And there's the two-minute warning. They rushed for 76 yards, a season low last week. Right now, 76 yards rushing, 2 minutes before halftime.
Woo! That was wild. You gotta see the numbers. Ooh, he almost got me. 0.14 yards away, technically. I get a close look at his foot, about a size 15. Scramble 14 yards, let it fly. And with all that going on, catch probability 31%. Yeah! Touchdown, baby!
What, you thought a little toe tickle was going to stop me? Come on now.
Next Gen Stats, powered by Amazon Web Services. AWS is out.
At Burger King, we have flame grilled beef, lettuce, onion, tomatoes. Wait, is that supposed to? Oh, yes, it is. The 2-for-5 mix and match deal, now at the side of PS5. Buy and play game in-app for a chance to win.
Your journey requires Liberty Mutual. They customize your car insurance so you only pay for what you need.
Wow, that will save me lots of money.
This game is boring.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 Liberty.
Knowing who we are is hard. It's hard. Eliminate who you
Superman for Halloween last night. Probably a few. Look at that. There's our Superman. Chris Spielman, King of the Beasts.
Nice.
Same pose.
Yeah, it's no nine-time sportscaster of the year in the state of Nebraska, but it's still something.
It'll work. I don't know, a poster. Here's Carr on first down, off the fingertips of Foster Moreau.
Now that's a throw he's got to make, and I get it's windy and all that. And they run a nice little wheel route. He's trying to throw it to the back shoulder, which I get, but I think Derek is more than capable of putting that ball on the numbers since there was nobody within 5 yards of the intended receiver. Missed opportunity.
It's been half of missed opportunities, Chris. The one in the end zone, the biggest on the Ruggs. Touchdown, no touchdown. Ruled, no touchdown on the field. Here's Ruggs. Inside the 40, a big hit leveled by Andrew Sendejo to drop him at the 39.
It's a good close by Sendejo. You know, playing the screen is like just playing the run. Everybody has a gap in open field tackle. Good job of getting that head off to the side, wrapping up.
Big third down and 6. Raiders out of timeouts. 1:25 to go, and the precipitation has really picked up.
You think?
I could check with Laura, but I think I can even see that from up here. Now we're talking.
It's blowing in, the wind's blowing in the booth here, Laura. It's very uncomfortable.
Richard with the carry, and Richard close to the first down at the 33-yard line.
I mean, this is such a good call, and I'm surprised, like, the Browns aren't playing this draw, right? And you can see that as the Raiders line up.
Now, as a stoppage in play, let's check in with Kurt Menefee. What do you have coming up?
Coming up on the Verizon halftime. Come in.
Trick or treat.
You know Halloween was yesterday, TV.
I want candy.
You are scared.
I want some candy.
No, okay, no candy, but highlights from around the league when we
candy.
Come back. On the Verizon Halftime Show.
Ma! Now looking forward to seeing what they've got in store. They're going to look to see whether or not this was a, this comes from the booth, obviously, whether or not this was a first down pickup from Jalen Richard. A buzz down from the replay booth. They're going to check the spot to make sure he did get the first down. While they do that, we'll step aside.
At Domino's, we're delivery experts. So when it comes to carry out, our team members had a few thoughts on how to make it even safer and more convenient.
Deliver it. Deliver it.
Deliver it.
Frisbee it.
So we went with what we do best. Delivery. To your car. Introducing Domino's Car Side Delivery.
Yep, truck's perfect.
We do the carrying out for you, contact-free, while you conveniently stay in your car.
Thank you.
Just pull up at the store, check in online, and we bring your food to you. Try Domino's.
this will stand as a first down for Jalen Richard and the Las Vegas Raiders.
Yeah, and how good have the Las Vegas running backs been at yards after contact? We've seen Booker do it, Jacobs do it, and now Richard.
This is kind of the weather day that we've had here. Some call it small hail, some call it sleet, some call it snow, all call it windy. Whatever you call it, it's November 1st in Cleveland. Carr with nobody open. Buying time, now he's just going to scramble. Sticks that ball forward as he goes out of bounds through the 28. No timeouts remaining for Las Vegas. Our Verizon halftime show coming up. Kurt, Terry, Howie, Michael, and Tony. Tua taking on the Rams. Good start so far for Tua and the Dolphins. And the Packers looking for their fourth straight win over the Vikings.
I think Waller's got to become a target down here eventually. Big target, 6'6".
Only one catch today for 8 yards. Carr in trouble, able to break free, and Carr upended. Big hit leveled by Kevin Johnson. Raiders again with no timeouts. They're going to hurry.
Good job in the back end of this Browns secondary of locking down receivers, forcing Carr to tuck and run.
10 to go with the drive, third and four. Carr over the middle, that's Richard. He's got a first down to the Browns 15-yard line. Again, no timeouts. They'll hustle to the line. Clock at 7 seconds, at six.
Sam's is up.
Derek Carr will spike the football with 2 seconds remaining in the half. And that'll bring Daniel Carlson on to try to give Las Vegas the lead. But of course, we've seen a lot of weird precipitation in this first half. Laura, what does the field look like as they come up for this field goal to try to close the half?
I'm standing in this end zone right now. They're cooking into, and I will tell you, for the first time today, there is no wind right now. There is no gust at this second.
That could change. This is an extra point length field goal, 33 yards for Daniel Carlson. This is the easier end to kick on, the high snap, and Carlson is true with the kick. And a 6-3 advantage for the Las Vegas Raiders at halftime. The play of the first half is brought to you by State Farm, and it's the play that could have been. The touchdown that almost was to Henry Ruggs III ruled out of bounds on the field. Upon review, the play stood, and it was not a touchdown. So we end the first half with 3 field goals on the board, a 6-3 advantage for Las Vegas. We now go to Kurt Menefee in Los Angeles for the Verizon halftime.
Welcome to the Verizon Halftime. This is the 5G America's been waiting for.
Well, weather has definitely impacted this game so far. 6-3 Vegas on top in Cleveland in a wild weather day.
All right, Vikings at the Packers. Heavy winds at Lambeau Field, over 40 miles an hour. That's just something I want no part of. Aaron Rodgers into the flat two. Devontae Adams, a 1-yard touchdown. Adams' second touchdown of the first half, 14-7. Green Bay, and of course Dalvin Cook back. He runs it in from 1 yard out. His second touchdown on the day. We've got a tie ball game, 14-all, Minnesota and the Vikings. Tua Tagovailoa, Tua out of Alabama.
Just go by Tua.
Devontae Parker, big slant. Everybody stared at me. Get over it. 7-0. It is 7-all now. Miami and the Rams, and Jakeem Grant returns this. Check it out. 88 yards for the touchdown. 21-7. An impressive Miami lead at the half. Jared Goff, 2 interceptions in the first half for the Rams. There it is. Keep it going. Steelers at the Ravens. Lamar Jackson. The last time he played against Pittsburgh, Ben wasn't playing. They won, but he had 5 sacks and 3 interceptions. This time he hands off to Gus Edwards from 1 yard out. 14-7 Ravens, and then Deontay Johnson and Marcus Peters. They start a fight. And then Matthew Judon comes in. He hits the official. There you go. There's the fight. Then the official. Pop him one good shot. Boom. See you later. You're out of the game. Go take a shower. That's Judon. Disqualified.
That's a big loss.
Baltimore 14-7 over Pittsburgh.
Yeah. He sold that hit. The official was pretty good at it.
New England. Quiet, fellas. I'm doing the highlights.
I'm sorry.
Patriots at the Bills. Zach Morris, 8-yard touchdown run. Exciting first half. 7-6. Don't touch it. Don't touch it. Buffalo on top of New England. Jets at Kansas City. Patrick Mahomes. Mahomes leading the AFC West. The Chiefs are with a record of 6-1. Mahomes underhand pass to Travis Kelce, a 3-yard touchdown, and then the dunk.
Yeah,
no tight end in the history of this league can make a dunk like that.
Don't hate on Tony Gonzalez, baby. He created it.
Titans at the Bengals. Joe Burrow out of LSU. Giovante Bernard takes it in, though, 12 yards out. And it's 17-7. Pittsburgh beat Tennessee. Now Cincinnati's on top, 17-7 over Tennessee. And Phillip Rivers to Nyheim Hines, a 29-yard touchdown. Hines celebrates, backflip. Yeah, there you go. He's not to work. They're working hard enough during the week to have that much energy. 20-7, Colts on top of the Lions.
All right, Howie, when you take a look at the first half stats, I'm looking here. Derek Carr, 8 of 16, 68 yards. Baker Mayfield, 5 of 10, 38 yards. This is not just because of the defense in this game. Weather has had an impact already.
Yeah, so you're saying you live in Vegas and you miss the Four Seasons. Let's take a trip to Cleveland. How about those fans? Are they dedicated? Derek Carr back looking for rugs deep. At a minimum, this is a 40-yard pickup. Potentially a touchdown. I mean, it hurts. Baker Mayfield, same thing, rolls out to the left, wide open in Juku, and that's probably a 20-yard pickup. It's going to come down to, in this game, who makes the fewest mistakes? Fumble, interception, not being able to handle the ball, and who can make the kick at the end of the game that could potentially
win. Well, we've already seen one kick start 40 yards to the right and middle to the left.
Who can make the kick?
Yeah, but what about, maybe they just run the football, though. I mean, Josh Jacobs is having some good yards on the ground, and Kareem Hunt is running the ball pretty well on the ground. Give them the ball. Why not?
Maybe that'll be one of those halftime adjustments.
Yeah. Total yards, 145-92.
Yeah. So it's set up to run it in the second half. Quick reminder for you, Thursday Night Football, it's a good one. A rematch of last year's NFC Championship game. Packers and the 49ers. Coverage begins 7:30 Eastern time right here on Fox. Now, before San Francisco takes on the Packers Thursday, they face Russell Wilson and the Seahawks today in America's Game of the Week. Some of you will get that. Others will catch Drew Brees and the Saints taking on the Chicago Bears. That all comes up after the second half of your game from wild, wet, and windy Cleveland.
Verizon 5G is here. With a coverage of 5G nationwide and in more cities, the performance of ultra-wideband. This is the 5G America's been waiting for.
911, what's your emergency?
It's Fox Mondays to the rescue.
Let's show them all we got!
With all new seasons of 911.
I'm ready to go back.
And 911 Lone Star.
I think we're going to have some fun together.
Oh, you bet we are.
911 and 911 Lone Star, back-to-back Mondays this January on Fox.
I wonder what people without all-wheel drive capability are doing right now.
football continues on Fox this week, and what a matchup we've got. It's a rematch of last year's NFC Championship game as the San Francisco 49ers host Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers. It all begins for you 7:30 Eastern Time, 4:30 Pacific, right here on Fox.
This is the moment America has been waiting for, with our future in the balance.
I was elected to fight for you.
The stakes couldn't be higher.
Nothing can stop us.
Tuesday, the countdown is over. America is voting. And only Fox News delivers the analysis and insight that America trusts from America's most experienced election team. Following real-time data on the Fox News app and every race as it happens from our best-in-class decision desk. Until we know. The 2020 election on Fox News Channel. America is watching.
Brace for impact.
This is awesome.
It's Friday Night SmackDown on Fox.
The hottest live show in all of entertainment.
Tap into network television's greatest spectacle as the baddest superstars on the planet are unleashed in prime time.
Power slam. Boom.
All new Friday Night SmackDown at 8 Eastern on Fox and the Fox Sports app.
TV's number one show is all new, The Masked Singer, Wednesday on Fox.
Today's the day. You know that feeling you woke up with?
Those butterflies don't ever go away.
But you have a plan. You're ready. Now execute it. November 3rd, Election Day.
We're counting on you to do your part and vote.
At our stadiums across the country that are now polling places.
Or your local polling place around the corner.
One player can make a difference. We need every player on our roster for this election.
Vote today. Vote.
An AFC showdown in the city of rock and roll as the Raiders and Browns battle. Second half, right around the corner. You're watching the National Football League on Fox.
With an unhinged yet loyal Jey Uso now by his side, Roman Reigns looks to continue his dominance. It's an all-new Friday Night SmackDown, live at 8 Eastern on Fox.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for letting us help you.
Thank you for trusting us.
Thank you for being patient.
For standing 6 feet apart.
For sending lunch.
And thank you.
Chris Spielman. I'm Kevin Kugler. It was a weird half with weather, wind, and not much in the air.
Yeah, and it's a field goal kicking, right? And the execution. Remember, the Raiders missed one. And I'll tell you, on that last kick, A.J. Cole did a great job getting the ball down. And look, if I'm Carlson, I'm trying to pick Parkey's brain. And if I'm Parkey, I'm saying, unless you're asking me about my personal life, I have no interest in talking to you right now. I'm not going to tell you anything I know.
So
right?
You walked away
good,
from him.
Good,
it's like, I'm done. I don't have any time for you. We've got things to deal with.
Kickers, what could they be talking about besides what they shot on the back nine yesterday?
I'm guessing they're talking about how bad it is to kick today.
Yes,
and
okay.
How we all should feel sorry
yes,
for these guys.
Yeah, it's cold over there waiting to kick.
I don't sense sympathy from you at all. As this kickoff will go into the end zone, barely, for the touchback. Laura Oakman, what did these coaches say about that first half?
Well, let me just say that wind I talked about dying down before that last field goal kicked back up again, you guys. And Kevin, I will not argue hail versus sleet with you on TV, man. You got to stop talking about that. I can just tell you, John Gruden said whatever it's called, it's absolutely affecting everything. Kevin Stefanski echoed it, saying it is what it is. We got to get the run game going, though, especially first and second downs to stay out of long third down situations. Kevin?
Well, it's called grapple, as I've been informed. A mix of sort of sleet and hail. So, really, Laura, you and I were both right in what we were calling that precipitation, but the meteorological term for it, as I found out because social media tells me everything, it's grapple. So now you know the rest of the story. So that sleet slash hail and wind is actually grapple and wind. We've had grapple today, Chris.
You got to be able to run and throw and make a play in the grapple.
You got to grapple with the grapple.
It's the rules still stay the same, whether it's grappling or not.
Second and seven. I've enjoyed working with you these last 8 weeks. This will probably be our last one. Now that we've brought grapple into the broadcast. The swing to Kareem Hunt, and Hunt fighting his way close to the first down.
Now that's what makes great running backs. We talk about it, vision, making people miss and always falling forward. First of all, this is not an easy pass for Baker to make, but it's on target, so the transition from catch to run is smooth. And Kareem, with the awareness to protect the football, with those legs always going forward, and he's always falling forward, getting an extra half yard if one's needed to be made.
First completion for Baker Mayfield since the first quarter. He was 0 for 4 in the second.